So again, let me open up the new file. I will take up the WDC here, and then of course with the just like this the previous simulation, we will use the MOSFETs here. We need to have an RL load, so let me place a resistance here as well as the inductance, and to see the current waveform we can use this current sensor. So we have this thing available here as well, and let me join them together. Next, what we need here is we need to add the gating blocks for all these four switches. So we have introduced these gating switches, and we have to connect the voltage here. To measure the voltage, we can connect this block here, and also to get it available on the scope, we need to put a probe over here. So let us say this is I of DC. So this is that we have discussed. This is IDC. Let us say this is the V naught, which is the output voltage. This is the output current I naught. And then we have to put in the values here. So as seen in the particular example, this resistance is equal to 10 ohm, and we have this inductance equal to this was 25 millihenry. So now what we need to see here is this is I naught. We have everything in place. So this is adjusted to a value which is equal to we should adjust this value equal to 116 volt. So let us say this is 116 volt. Now we have to actually design the logic of turning on these switches S1, S2, S3 and S4. The simple way is that you should always remember that this S1 is to be turned on from alpha to 180 degree plus of alpha, and this S2 is to be turned on from 0 degree to 180 degree minus alpha, and we need to turn it on from 360 degree minus alpha to 360 degree. Then we have this S3 is turned on from 180 degree minus alpha to 360 degree minus of alpha, and S4 should be turned on from 0 to alpha and from 180 degree plus alpha to 360 degree. So all of the switches in turn will be active for 180 degree of the output waveform. So let us say for this S1, because the output frequency is 60, let me bring it to 60, and that we need to, for the third harmonic, it should be from 30 degree to 180 degree plus alpha, which is equal to 210 degree. So for this S2, which is in this diagonal pair, it should be turned on for four, the number of points are four. So it is from 0 degree to 180 degree minus of alpha, which makes it equal to 150 degree. And then we have 360 degree minus of alpha, which is 330 degree up till 360 degree. So this is how we will turn on the switch S2. For the switch S3, we have again, let me check this one if I have changes. Okay, this is 60 hertz. For this S3, we need to turn it on from 180 degree minus of alpha, which is 150 degree, up till 360 degree minus alpha, which is 330 degree. Also for this switch S4, this is 60 degree. We need to turn it on from 0 to alpha, which is 30 degree, and then from 180 degree plus alpha, which is 210 degree, to 360 degree. So that's all for the adjustment. Let us put in the simulation block here and play it for 0.1 second. Okay, so let me check. Okay, this one we need to adjust it a little bit. just a minute, we have an error here. Okay, so okay, now it's okay. Let us turn it on. Now let us see, go directly to the V naught. So this is the V naught. I think we have an issue here. Let me check. So now we have rectified the issue. The issue here is that we forgot to make these number of points equal to 4. So now if I turn this this simulation on and we get the value of this V naught, so you can see here that this V naught has 0 periods in it. So we have a 30 degree delay here, and then we have a 30 degree delay here for this positive waveform, and then we have again we have a 30 degree delay here for the negative half cycle. So overall this time period is equal to the 60 degree while this is 30 degree. Similarly, now if we go for the FFT analysis of this particular waveform and I restrict this to equal to the 10th harmonic, maybe yeah, this is okay. So you can see here that we have with us is this, this is the fundamental component here. So you can see 127 volt is a fundamental component, and if I move ahead, so you can see here at this particular 150 hertz frequency, this is 160, this is 170, this is 180. So at 180, this is the third harmonic. But because of the adjustment of alpha equal to 30 degree, there is no third harmonic in the output waveform. So if I move ahead, then we have this fifth harmonic present, which is 25 volt. So remember that we have earlier done this example and we calculated this in this particular example that this V5 is equal to 25.5 volt. So you can see here that we have 25.5 volt available as a fifth harmonic. Then we have available is the seventh harmonic, but you can see here we do not have the ninth harmonic available. Let us expand this to 900 hertz and to see all the triplet harmonics are actually absent. So we do not have the third harmonic available, and then we, if we move ahead, we do not have the ninth harmonic available. So this is also zero. Again we have the 11th harmonic available, which is at 660 hertz, and that is equal to 1.16 volt, and this is exactly what we have discussed here. This is 11.6 and this is 1.16 e to the power plus 1, so this is 11.6 volt. Similarly, if I go for this I naught here, then this I naught have all of these waveforms. So we can see here that the fundamental component that we have seen here, it is equal to 9.31 ampere. And for the example, it was decided that this I1 should have a value equal to 9.27 ampere. So that is how we can actually get rid of the unwanted harmonics without incorporating the bulky filters there. Thank you very much.